they feel very, like, real life.
Stop. Start over.
Hi, I'm Jonna, and I'm here to give you a short review of a game called Detective. It's a game my husband and I recently got into. We're really terrible at it, but we like it a lot, so I thought I'd share it with you. So in this game, you are a detective. You can play solo or with up to 5 people. So you start with a case and they'll offer you an introduction and a variety of leads to follow. Now each of these leads is essentially a lead card, and this lead card will provide evidence for you or some bits of information related to the case, and then offer additional leads for you to follow. Now these cards cost time. Some cards will take 3 hours, some cards will only take 1 hour. But the interesting thing about this game is that you only have a few days to solve the case, and each day you can only put in up to 8 hours. If you put in overtime, you get stress tokens. These stress tokens will make the game end early or will count as points against you at the end of the game. When you come to the end of the game and you're ready to answer all the questions, you'll use the computer and the game app, and it will prompt you with questions, and hopefully you'll be able to answer all of them. If you can, you'll get a really high score and be an expert detective. If not, you might be more like us and just be a really lousy detective, but it's still super fun.
I find it a lot better than consulting to Sherlock Holmes Consulting.
Yeah, that's the only other game that we played that would be comparable.
Yeah, and this one's much better. If you like Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective, you would like this game, I believe. And if you didn't like Consulting Detective, you might like this game. It's less tedious.
There's structure to it. There's, like, they give you a direction to go into, and they give you a lot of choice.
I like that it's set modern day-ish.
Yeah. It says you can play 5 people. Would that be fun? I don't know if it would be.
I don't know. It's pretty perfect with 2 people. I'd play it solo. Like, if you don't.
I don't have any interest in adding more people.
I want to say I am not a fan of when board games have apps and electronic things.
Oh, yeah.
And I know some people were concerned because part of this game is online. And I'm telling you that it is worth the inconvenience of having to have an electronic at the table. The database that you use for the part of the game is a top-notch and original idea. It really helps bring the immersion together, and it's work.
Yeah, it's good. Cool that it's actual locations.
Yeah,
that they're set there. They're on Google Maps, and they often pull in like historical figures.
Good job, Portal Games.
I like how the cases don't end in one neat little package. There's a lot of unopened answers. There's a lot of open-ended questions. It feels kind of true to life, where you can solve a case and get enough to convict the person, but there's still a lot of mystery. I like that.
You don't know everything.
You don't know everything,
but you know enough.
And you feel a little like, did we do it? Did we solve it? When you're getting your questions at the end to see how you scored, it's like, whoa, I didn't know about the feather duster. Did you know about the feather duster? Like,
I had a hunch.
It'll reveal.
Like, it makes you sneeze.
That I made up. That's not a spoiler at all. But that's how you feel. You're like, oh, I didn't know about that guy. Thanks, Daniel, for doing this video with me.
You're welcome. It's tolerable.
I know you don't like to, but I appreciate it.
Start over.
I like how they don't